Welcome back to Carrie's Culinary Crafts. And if you're new, welcome. Here on Carrie's Culinary Crafts, we talk all things food. And today I have a food prep day for you. My son that lives in college, he asked me if I had any, you know, ground beef that I had already cooked that he could take back to school with him. Yes, my older son, even though he used to help me all the time in the kitchen, he just doesn't cook. I mean, it doesn't surprise me if he, you know, has a box of donuts for dinner. You know, it's just, it is what it is with college kids, right? But when I went and visited him, you know, a couple or over the summer, and I did a field trip vlog with you guys where I stayed with my son for a week in college. I had did a lot of food prep for him, and with that, I also cooked him an abundance of some meats, and then just stuck them in the freezer, so they were already cooked. And he could make like a quick beef stroganoff or something, you know, whatever he wanted to do with the meats that were cooked in the freezer. Well, because I did that, he actually did cook himself some meals. So that made me happy. And so when he asked me again if I could give him some already cooked ground beef, I didn't even hesitate. I'm like, yes, I will certainly do that because I have food prep days all the time. So that is just something I can just add on my list for that day. So today I'm going to go ahead and show you a bunch of like meats that I go ahead and prep ahead of time. It just saves a lot of time. In making other meals, like, of course I do, like, I have all my canning proteins. I have canned chicken. I have canned ground beef. I have, you know, all the canned stuff. But I also like fully cooked stuff in my freezer, too. I like to have options. And then because my son had requested the frozen as opposed to the canned, in fact, I don't even have any canned ground beef. I have canned taco meat, but I don't even think I have any canned ground beef anymore. So I'm going to need to give myself some of that. But anywho, so today I'm going to go ahead and kind of cook up all the things. And when I have a day like this, the first thing that I like to do is cook up bacon. Bacon produces lots of bacon fat. And so since I'm going to be cooking several meats today and pretty much spending all day in the kitchen, I am going to cook using one cast iron skillet that I started and cooked all of my bacon in, and it produced all that bacon grease. So all the meats that I cook today, I'm just going to cook right in that pan along with that bacon grease. Only adds extra flavor to everything. So if this is something that interests you, come along with me. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button down below. Here on Carrie's Culinary Crafts, we do all things food. And today is a food prep day. Okay, to start off my food prep day, I am going to start off with some butcher box bacon. So I'm going to get this pan is screaming hot. So I'm going to go ahead and put this bacon in here and get it cooking. I always love to start off with a pack of bacon to get that wonderful bacon grease in order to cook the rest of my meats with. Just as a whole extra layer of flavor to your other meats whenever you cook them. Okay, Okay, I'm gonna turn that down a little bit. That's really smoking. I'm gonna put this lid on for right now. And I'm gonna go ahead and cook up this bacon until it's mostly crispy. It'll be like not 100% crispy. There'll be a little bit of chewiness and a little bit of crispiness. That's the way we all like our bacon here. When you cook in cast iron and have it screaming hot, it takes no time at all to cook up some bacon. This bacon has only been on here about 2 minutes, and it's already well on its way. And as they get done, I will go ahead and just pull them off and put them on a paper towel lined plate. And there we go. Less than 5 minutes, we have ourselves some cooked bacon. And now I will clean out some of these bacon bits in here. And I have all that wonderful bacon grease in there that I'm going to go ahead and cook my beef and my chicken in. another thing that I like to do on my food prep days is prep any veggies that need to be prepped. Wash them, dry them, cut them, whatever I need to do with them. And my husband eats celery every day as his mid-afternoon snack. So I like to have celery all cut, cleaned, and cut up for him. So when he comes down to grab his snack, he can just grab it and go. And I cut off all the bottoms and all of like the leaves, and I keep that. I will put that in a bag that is in my freezer in order to make some stock whenever I need to make stock. Because I have, you know, big turkey carcass from Thanksgiving that I have in the freezer. So I'm going to go ahead and put these in a bag in the freezer. And whenever it's time to make some turkey broth, I will have all of my carcasses and my veggies ready to go. So I'm going to go ahead and get these cut up and then washed and dried off. And then I'll bring you back for the next food prep. Okay, I have my celery nice and washed. I let them sit in the drainer for a little bit. Now I'm gonna go ahead and put them on a nice clean towel. And I'm going to get them as dry as I can in my nice clean towel. And you don't have to get all the water off, because I put a paper towel at the bottom of the celery container, so if there's any moisture, then it will drain down into the paper towel. Okay. And then I'm just going to go ahead and put my celery in the container. So anytime I want celery, like for cooking or for snacking, or my husband or son, you can just reach in, lift the lid, and grab some celery. And I also do carrots as well, but I already have some carrots done in the refrigerator. So this was the only veggie prep that I had to do on this day. And there we go. Veggie prepped for my husband for the week. And one of the other things that I do on a prep day is I go ahead and boil up a dozen eggs. We all like boiled eggs in the family. We like to snack on them, and we also love boiled eggs on our salads. So we have salads a lot. So pretty much every other week, I go ahead and boil some eggs. And I boil mine in the Instant Pot. just because it makes for super easy peeling. And then everybody knows that this container, you can't really read it, it's kind of washed off, but everybody knows that in this container of 12 eggs, this is always boiled eggs. So everybody always knows if they want a boiled egg, where to grab them from. Okay, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this food prep day. I couldn't do any talking during the cooking, which is why I kind of did an intro and an outro sitting here at my my dining table. But I had a house full of people, so I didn't want to have to worry about, you know, hearing conversations and that sort of thing. So, and constantly interrupted and everything. So I hope you guys enjoyed this food prep day. And if you like to see more of these, let me know, because normally I do this kind of stuff behind the scenes. I don't do it that often, but I do a lot of food prep days because I like the convenience of it. And also, as I mentioned, my son, if he wants to take cooked chicken or cooked turkey or cooked bacon, cooked ground beef back to school with him, I would have it on hand. And it's best, you know, if I have, he prefers to have it frozen, because then I could just give it to him in a cooler with ice packs and he can put the majority of it in the freezer, but whatever he's going to be using, then he can just stick in the refrigerator. So, but I do these often because I, you know, I like to have already cooked proteins, makes for super fast, quick and easy meals. So, all right, friends, I will see you on the next one. Bye.